that.
But in the second term, South Australia ran riot. Kernaghan kicked three great goals, while Russell and Francis started to cut up the Vicks in the centre, and South Australia kicked 10-2. Coach Billy Goggin appealed to the Victorians' pride, and his players responded, and with Paul Roos moving to centre-half forward, kicked 2 goals to get back in the game in the third quarter. In the final term, the lead changed 4 times, and when Paul Couch slammed one home, the Vicks looked safe.
Goes for goal, and might have kicked it, he has, I think.
But a magnificent goal to Tony Hall on the run gave the home side some chance.
Oh, look at this! Oh, what a kick, Tony Hall!
Then, a missed mark by Gary O'Donnell set up Adam Saliba before Tony Francis sealed the game as South Australia got up by 13 points.
It was like a championship fight. It could have gone either way, and a draw probably could have been a fitting result the way it went. But 27-minute mark into the quarter, we're 7 points up or something, and we're looking at each other with a bit of a smile on our face. Next minute, we're 13 points down, and it's hit the fan.
But that was spectacular, tough and hard. Victoria made a fantastic game of it, but our guys just did what needed to be done at the right time.
I think you really do lift a bit when you get behind, and we were really struggling in the first quarter. I think that was made it a little bit more special. A couple of times we had to come from behind, even at the end there, so... You know, we found a bit when we had to.
On arrival back in Melbourne, most players were off to their club doctors. Tony Shaw with a badly bruised thumb.
Yeah, no worries, Ed. No hassles with that, just a bit of bruising, that's all.
Did you feel like thumping a player called Francis and another one called Russell at any stage?
Oh, yeah, in that second quarter when they kicked a few goals, it was a bit rough, but... They played really well. It was good for Collingwood too, I think, with Scotty getting back into a bit of form.
Mil Hanna with an ankle injury.
I did in the first couple of minutes of the game. It just looked like I jarred it. It just got worse as the game went on, so in the end I sort of was pretty hard to put any pressure on it.
And Jim Stein's a knee.
Well, in the past, I've sort of recovered quite quickly from injuries, so hopefully, the same will happen and I can get out there on Saturday.
Essendon's Greg Anderson also injured his knee.